Hey, what's going on, guys? Coach Seth here, Superior Athlete. So today I wanted to talk about how you guys can actually measure your vertical jump without really anything. I'm gonna go over some of like the best ways to measure your vertical, but I also want to let it be known that you don't need all this fancy equipment. You can probably use stuff just laying around your house in order to measure your vertical jump. Before we get into it, I want to let you guys know that I have a Teespring store. If you want to support me, support the channel. That's a great way to do it. And also you're gonna get a pretty cool t-shirt as well. So make sure to check that out. That's gonna be linked up in the description. Also, if you haven't already and you enjoy my videos and you wanna see more of my videos, make sure to subscribe and click the little bell to get notified each time I post a video. All right, so measuring your vertical is really like the first steps of improving your vertical. You need to get that measurement down for motivational purposes, to know where your vertical is. And that way you can kind of keep track of it over time, basically just to know if you are improving your vertical. And if you're not, then you need to change things up a little bit. And then if you are, you know to kind of stay the course and you know you're heading in the right direction. But it starts with measuring your vertical. So I'm gonna start off with the most accurate way to measure your vertical and kind of like the professional way to measure your vertical. And that's gonna be using a vertec. So this is a professional vertical jump tester here. Now, this isn't going to be completely necessary for all of you guys for a number of different reasons. This is something that's going to take up a lot of space. It's kind of a big investment as well. But if you want to get the most accurate way to measure your vertical, this is going to be one of the best ways. So I'm going to kind of go over a way you can measure your vertical. It's basically free. You need a couple things, but a lot of these things you're probably just going to have laying around your house. So you can probably get this done today and you don't need very many things. But first I want to talk about a couple apps that I've tried out. I wanted to try out some apps because I know that would be like the most convenient way if there was a good one out there and that was accurate and was easy as well. So I've tested out a couple of these. I tested out multiple times and the end result of these was kind of underwhelming. One of them's called Jumpster and the other one's called VertVision. Jumpster was the one that was just, it just did not work for me. I just didn't like how it was done. I didn't think the accuracy was there. You know, it was just not a very good one. The other one was VertVision. This one has pretty good potential because it actually makes sense on how it works and everything. Tested using it multiple times and I kind of compared like the traditional way and I compared it using a vertec as well. And the big problem I have with this one is this doesn't seem to be very accurate. These apps just didn't really work for me. If you want, you can give them a try and they might be good for you. The VertVision app started to give me the hopes of it being consistent, if anything. Now, if it's consistent, that's pretty good because if it can stay consistent, then you at least know, have a number of where it's at. But for me, it was consistent for a while and then it just kind of started to get all over the place the more I tested it. So I wouldn't recommend either one of those. But from good sources, I've heard multiple people talk about kind of a paid version of an app. I don't remember exactly which one it was, but you can kind of do your own research on that. And they say that this app is pretty good. I have not tested it out myself, but some pretty good sources kind of recommended this app. I think it's on the cheap side as well. Seems like it might be like $10 or maybe like $2 a month or something like that. I'm not exactly sure, but I know it's a paid one. So it might not be a good fit for all of you, but that is something to consider. But do your own research, check more apps out if this is the way you want to be able to do it. I'm sure there are better apps than the ones that I tried. Okay, so I'm going to show you guys how I like to measure your vertical, kind of the traditional way. There's only a few things that you're going to need. All you're going to need is some tape. And the stickier the better on the tape. So just make sure it's pretty sticky. If like Scotch tape is all you have, then that should work. It's just gonna be kind of a pain to get it to stick to the wall. But other thing you're gonna need is a tape measure and a wall. And the only thing you need with the wall is make sure that wall is tall enough, obviously, for you to be able to jump as high as you can. And so it's gotta be a tall wall, but those are the only three things that you need for this. As far as the ground surfaces, you can do this outside. You know, the grass and the ground is gonna have a little bit of give to it. So it's probably not gonna be like as accurate as what like a hardwood floor would be, but we're just using what we have at this point. So the first thing you need to do with this is get a strand of tape and wrap it around your two center fingers. okay? And make sure the top of the tape hits the top of your middle finger here. And that's gonna be basically your highest reach. So don't cheat on this or anything. Make sure to get that top of the tape right at that center of that middle finger. And the first thing we're gonna do is stand all the way up against the wall. We're gonna get the standing reach. So make sure your heels are flat on the floor and we're reaching all the way up and you got that good posture right up against the wall, and then you're gonna stick it right there. So leave that there first. And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna repeat that same process with the tape. Make sure it's on the center of that middle finger. And then you're going to, you know, get your feet set. And then we're gonna do a standing jump. So we're not taking a step or anything. If you want to, you can do a one step or even an approach. It's a little bit more difficult to do it up against the wall that way. So just be careful. We're just gonna focus on the standing jump for now. So we're not taking a step with this. Get your feet shoulder width apart and jump as high as you can and then stick it at your peak. So you may need to take a few times with this, 3 to 5 times of trying. Try to get your tape to be lined up with that standing reach tape. The more it's lined up, the more accurate it's gonna be. Do this a few times and then you're just gonna use that top one and you're just gonna measure the difference. And it's just as simple as that, and that will be your standing vertical jump. So make sure to try this out, and I'm curious to know what your guys' vertical jump is. So try this out and let me know in the comments what your vertical is. I hope this video was helpful for you guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions or anything, drop a comment down below. And don't forget to let me know what your vertical is in the comment section. And also make sure to subscribe, click the bell to get notified for each one of my videos. And I will see you guys in the next one.